14, I wanted to be a psychiatrist. But coming from a working class background, I was given the message, don't get too big for your boots. So I didn't get too big for my boots, and I went to work in a bank, got bored, did lots of other various different careers, but then realised it was mostly to do with working with people, and I came across transactional analysis, which is the type of psychotherapy we do here. I really liked it. I did a short course in it, liked it more, all with the view of upskilling myself in the current job I was in. So after the first year, I carried on, and then I became a psychotherapist and sacked off the other job, and here I am. When I came to see Bob, and he explained more about the training, it felt very good. It felt solid and trustworthy, you know, and that's stood me in good stead, because it has been. I did my 4 years of training, and then after that I got what we call a CTA, which is the qualification for psychotherapists in transactional analysis. That's quite a lengthy process, and that took me a couple of years. And then a year after that, I decided to become a PTSTA, which means I can also supervise and train other therapists. I haven't planned to be a specialist, but I do quite a lot of couples work. And I find from doing that anyway that when I'm working with individuals, it's quite rare that their relationships don't come into the reason why they're attending therapy with me. I think for most of us, the prospect of coming here is difficult. The prospect of change is difficult. But I find personally anyway, that when we're at the point of the prospect of staying as we are becomes more painful than the prospect of change, that's the time to pick up the phone. For me, a knowledge of psychotherapy is like having an extra sense. It is painful at times. At times we have a laugh, it's not all doom and gloom. Sometimes, you know, it really is a lot of fun too. It's a journey. It's a great journey to take, and it just increases your quality of life. So.